It's a sad day. We're saying goodbye to the corn, at least this corn, because there's more corn right there. Not this guy, that patch. We're taking this corn patch down today in today's vlog and a lot more.
Checking for done this.
Jacques is just, I don't know what he's doing there.
I'm trying to see if there's any pollen left out of curiosity.
Yeah.
It doesn't seem to be.
It is kind of fun to do. Oops. It's in my eyes now.
It's an amateur move there.
Honestly, that was a noob move.
Like that.
Yeah, we're definitely in it.
All right, let's look hard. All right. Don't mess with the lopper gang.
Mm-mm.
We're coming. Okay, so the plan is for the corn, we're just gonna lop it at the bottom and then isolate all the ears, because what's happening, the reason why I'm harvesting it right now, it's most of it's actually done, but some of it is technically not, but there's a cornworm or an earwig in every single top of every single cob, and so I'll take a smaller cob over no cob. So that's the plan. We're gonna chop it down. We got another corn plot going. Let's do it. Look at this pile of corn. I was telling Jacques, I feel like a farmer for the first time in my life, because there's so much you don't even bother organizing it until later. So why don't you do a peel right now? Let's see what it looks like.
So this one was pretty low on the on the corn.
Yeah.
So I'm guessing it's gonna be pretty small. Oh.
See, that's what's showing up in every single, hold on. That's what's showing up in every single one right now. Little cornworm, one, maybe two if we're unlucky. And
oh, yeah.
Look what it does.
Oh my God, that's
it
a huge one.
It just decimates. Holy, oh my. Dude, no. No, I don't like that at all.
That's gonna be a bad
little
one.
Ooh,
actually, never mind.
Actually, it's not.
Wow.
Wait, how is this in the Astronomy Domine patch?
Oh yeah, it actually looks like the blue jade.
Looks like blue jade.
Huh, maybe a little bit across.
A little accidental planting by this guy right here.
Not bad.
Honestly, here's the thing. If you cut that right there, you still have a little baby corn.
Yeah.
It's not bad.
Couple bites.
Little muncher.
Why not?
Not a big deal. All right, we're gonna process this and we'll see you in a second.
So we're just gonna separate all the ears into this little tray right here. All the other biomass will go in the wheelbarrow. I'm gonna test out this old chipper shredder. It's electric one that I picked up a while ago off Craigslist in just a second, because this is fantastic, fantastic organic matter. We could just turn it right back into this if we wanted to, if we could get that particle size small. So let's go.
Yeah.
Oh wow, dude, that's so weird.
Was that the silk? Oh, I mean, that was the tassel. Wow.
Look at that.
That's so weird.
It's like, it has that same issue, but this one actually fertilized.
And that was on top of the corn?
I actually don't remember when I pulled it off.
Wow.
But that's really weird.
That's definitely a weirdo.
I like it. Jesus Christ.
Sorry.
Hey, Jacques just is abusing me over here. He just corn slapped me.
That might have been an accident.
Might have been.
Might have been.
I'll come up on your performance review. The corn boys are back, and it's time to shuck. And the reason why is because I know there's a worm or an earwig in each of them. So let's get to it. I've got my cutting board out here because I want to make sure that before I bring it inside, I just cut off any messed up tissue. Oh, there's a worm. I got a wig in mine.
Yeah, it's not a good find.
Not a good find. This little piece right here, I'll just do that. And yes, this won't last very long, so I'm gonna process it. And that'll be either in this episode or another episode on the Homestead channel. For those who are wondering why our corn is so irregular, it's a landrace variety called Astronomy Domine. And I mean, a true botanist would know more than me, but to me it feels weird to call a landrace a true variety, because it seems like there's so much genetic diversity in it that it just varies way too much for me to feel comfortable calling it like something's anywhere close to stable. However, it's important to add in, basically, to mix back in new genetics into different crosses and all sorts of stuff like that, which corn is just absolutely one of the most popular and crossed crops out there. So it is still important to have, it just feels a little odd to call it a variety, yeah. I guess, in my mind.
You're not gonna have anything consistent.
No.
For sure.
Wow, this one got messed up.
Yeah. No, those worms were definitely.
Well, here's the thing though, it's like you lose 15% of your ear, right?
Right.
But the rest of this looks amazing.
Yeah.
You know?
It looks beautiful. It
looks really good. I don't even know if that's worth it.
Probably yeah,
a little good. Bite. Little corn popper.
Yeah, so it's still consistently every single one has a worm.
Yeah.
And interestingly, it's only one worm in each
yeah,
one.
Yeah, yeah. I did see one with two, but that was far and away not the norm. Yeah, so we'll still have to wash these, but we're just gonna process them up. So take a look at this. Ooh, it's hot. The silk looks like a floppy hairdo. And when they're this vibrant and sort of fresh still, first of all, they smell good, but second of all, nothing pollinated. So this one just didn't get pollen from the tassels coming down, which is unfortunate, but little known thing, you can actually save all these silks right here, and you can use these in a tea. I don't know much about medicinal gardening, but I do know that some people do really like to save it, so maybe I'll give this a try.
Yeah, my mom used to do that all the time.
Really? What does it taste like? Just like mild
just
corn?
Just kind of tastes like corn, yeah.
So surprised.
I'm like, cool.
What did she say what she was doing it for?
Or? I don't remember. I think it was good for the kidneys or something.
Right. But it's always good for some random part of the body that you don't think that like, you don't really have a problem with in
right.
the first place. Oh. How mad would you be if I just threw it at you right now?
I would put it right back on. If you want to go for it.
I could die by our own sword. By the way, this knife is from New West Knife Works. They sent this out, and it is so sharp. It is super fun to use. I love a good chef knife. I'm obsessed with it. In another life, I would just be a chef, I think.
Yeah, I've often thought that myself.
Yeah. I thought, like, what if I just left this world and went into the world of, like, fine dining or something? Anyways, look at how much corn we have. Should we do a count?
Let's yeah,
count.
Sure.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then the corn sword counts as 3, so it's 30. So 30 ears, and I already pulled off maybe like 12 to 15 or so. For this landrace heirloom variety with some interesting, you know, conditions growing, get this guy out of here. Get out of here. Oh, you feel it. It's actually pretty muscular.
It's like muscular.
It's muscular. I don't like that at all. Anyways, probably about 45 ears of corn off of that. Maybe 50, not too bad. I actually would have liked to see like 60 to 75, but I wasn't growing this perfectly hybridized corn that optimized
right.
exactly what you wanted. So not too bad. So that's it, corn harvest.
So guess who showed up at the homestead? The epic mom, Cotter, eating lunch.
Yep.
I'm gonna make this corn silk tea. We'll see how it tastes. We'll get the epic mom's approval. Okay, I'm just using a Googled recipe of a quarter cup of corn silk that's fresh to about a cup of water, steep it for 5 minutes, so we will see how this goes. Time will tell. It's been about 5 minutes. This little tea steeper is nice because you just put it on top and the water goes down. So there's one for you, Mom. This one's for me.
Cheers.
Cheers. All right, let's see what you think.
Like corn.
Yeah. No?
Not my favorite, I wouldn't say. So it tastes like corn.
Yeah. Let's see.
If it was medicinal, does it have
It's properties? Supposedly supposed to be. I don't mind it. It's kind of more grassy than
yeah.
actual
it's
corn,
sort
but.
Of earthy. I mean, it's not bad. It's just not my favorite.
It's not bad. It's not bad. I probably didn't do it right. So if you know how to do it, drop it in the comments.
It's about 10 p.m. It was a long day. I'm very, very tired. But what I'm gonna do is process some of this corn. I can't eat all this fresh, and husked corn does not last very long at all. So I'll reserve a few ears. I have some in the fridge already. But what I'm gonna do is blanch it. So I've got a pot of boiling water that's heating up right now. And what we're gonna do is toss each of these into that water for about 6 minutes or so. I use the Ball Blue Book for canning, and they have blanching recommendations if you're gonna freeze the corn. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna then toss it into a bucket full of ice water for roughly as long, just to get it nice and cool. And then I'm gonna cut it all off. So I'm gonna take a knife, run it right down the side. We'll cut it off in a whole kernel fashion, dry that out, and put it in the freezer.
We're about at that boil point, so I'm about to drop in the corn. Let's go, 6 minutes. Just look at how that color changes. It's been 6 minutes. We're getting it into the ice bath ASAP. We have to treat this corn with respect, my friends. We have to treat this corn with respect because it took us not that long to grow it, but long enough that we don't want to mess it up. So in it goes. Batch two is coming soon.
The blanching is complete. It is now time to get the corn off the cob, and I'm going to use a super sharp chef's knife. What I'm gonna do is this little hack that I found where it's annoying to do this, right? Because you're gonna slip or you're gonna do all sorts of weird, annoying things. The kernels will get all over the place. Put it in a bowl, put something on top that is smaller in diameter than the cob, and then just come down. Ooh, life hack that actually works right there. Look at that. It's not the most stable thing I've ever done in my life. I just lost some. Not the most stable thing I've ever done, like I was saying. Maybe I'll put a little silicone pad down there or something, but it seems to work better than what I was about to do. So let's process this. Okay, I need to use something that does not have a ramped edge like that. Let's try the trusty Zojirushi instead. That's better. I think a bundt pan is the classic implementation. But this will work. All this is gonna get chopped and composted. Never did I think that life would take me in a direction where posing next to a bowl of corn that I blanched and grew myself would be what I would be doing on a Thursday night at 11 p.m. But nevertheless, my friends, it looks pretty good. I think the variety really starts to show up when you blanch. Really cool. So all I'm gonna do now is pack this up and put it in the freezer. Corn's done, late. Relaxing out here in the backyard. Nothing in the backdrop anymore. We're gonna have to plant something there. But it is nice to come out here, dark, quiet, the fence encases everything, the shed's right there. Oh, it's like a perfectly warm summer's night. It is time to probably have a sleepover out here in the garden sometime. That's it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you have a thing that you'd like to do with corn, pop it down in the comments because I would love to know. I'm always trying to improve my cooking. So, till next time, good luck in the garden and keep on growing.